Hey guys, can you guess what is behind this door? Let me show you. That I'm removing before I clean up the whole shelf and rearrange the books again. Normally before the rainy season, I lay out all the books in the sun. Otherwise, these books will become kind of yellow due to the moisture and always being closed in the cupboard. So this is an annual routine that I do, and I'll be showing you all my book collection. So let's go. If you're a book lover like me, I'm sure you also must have collected lot of books over the years. And it's always a struggle finding place where to keep the books. It should be handy so that we can read the books whenever we want. Otherwise, you'll be getting out of the habit of reading. So when I built the house, I decided that I needed a place where I could accommodate lot of books. And another thing, a secret I want to let you in is that I'm not very fond of lending books to everyone. I'm very fond of my books and I like to keep them well maintained. So this I found to be like a secret hideaway for my books where I can keep it. And my husband is also an avid book reader, so he also wants the books to be easily accessible. So we made this space behind the door into a small book rack. But though it looks small, I can accommodate nearly 400 books in this. These are the locks, and below that, when I open the door, I have like 8 inches of space left here, which I have used. And when the door is open, you can hardly see the bookshelf. This is made of plywood, so it's long lasting. And also the size of the bookshelves I have decided based on the kind of books that I have, and the depth is like around 8 inches. And in total, I have 7 shelves, and we have got a magnetic door closer, so I can easily close the door without any gaps, so that any insects or cockroaches and all cannot go inside. This is an oil-based paint, because of which it's very easy to clean. The inside is also painted with the same enamel paint, which is very easy to clean. If you want, you can also stick laminates here, but I didn't want to go for laminates because anyway it's concealed inside and paint would be sufficient. But if you have laminates, you can go for that too. So once I finish wiping all the shelves down, I'll allow it to air for some time and dry properly so that there's absolutely no moisture before I place the books back.
As you can see, I have arranged all the books down here. One problem I was facing was that all the books had got mixed up and I was not able to see the titles of the books. So that is the reason I decided to clean everything and then rearrange it. So here I have sorted all the books according to the author, and as you can see, I have lot of books.
They're mostly fiction, and most of them are related to mystery and these kind of stories. This is Sydney Sheldon's. I have a lot of books of this author. This is one of the first books of Jeffrey Archer that I had read, and it's nearly 35 years old and has been with me. After that, I have collected a lot of books of Jeffrey Archer. The other author that I have is John Grisham. Here also I have most of the books of this author. I can't take the full credit for collecting all these books. My husband and daughter are also avid readers, and they also buy a lot of books. So we have collected a number of them over the years. Other authors that I have are Earl Stanley Gardner's Perry Mason series. My husband is a fan of his, and you can see I have lot of books of Perry Mason here. All are not new books, some are even second hand. The ones which he didn't find new, my husband has bought these second-hand books. They are also in good condition itself. So you can see the entire length. This whole row is almost full of Perry Mason books. I also have books of other authors like Robin Cook, Dan Brown, Desmond Bagley, Frederick Forsyth, Alistair MacLean. This collection to our books is The Lord of the Rings, which my daughter wanted to buy the full series. I also have some books of numerology and palmistry also. Once upon a time I had developed a fascination to learn this and had bought all these books. I have started reading a lot of non-fiction books, and slowly my collection is growing from those also. From here to here you can see they are all non-fiction books, and the book that I am currently reading is Atomic Habits, which is a super book, and I recommend that all of you read it if you want to make any changes in your habits and want to grow. This is the book for you. Another book that I read recently was Becoming, and this was really an eye-opener, and I came to know what a down-to-earth person she is. It's a beautiful book, you should read it. Another book which I would recommend you read is Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill. This is a beautiful book if you want to achieve your goals. So all these books are pretty thin, so you'll be able to complete them fast, and definitely you should check out all these books. These hardbound books that you see here are of Kannada, and this is my husband's collection, and the name is Chandrakanta Santati. He hunted all over the place to get this series. This is actually a story of all mythological and you know, fictitious characters. And this series used to come on TV also as Chandrakanta. So he searched all over and finally bought all this full series. Childhood, I was very much interested in reading books which were filled with mystery and you know, have some kind of thrill in that. So most of the books that you see here belong to that kind of a category. And of course I have a few romantic books. I was really not a romantic by heart, so didn't go for those kind of books. These books are just a part of my collection. I have lot of other books which I have stored in the loft. And also I have very old books which were from my childhood, and also what my daughter has collected, and those will be including Nancy Drew, Archie Comics, and its lightens, Mallory Towers and all that. And I will be sharing with you that all those books in another video. So now I'll be airing all these books out in the sun, and if any pages are coming out, I'll be repairing them and sticking them again, and later I'll be replacing all that in my book rack, which I will show later.
All the books are arranged according to the author, and I will be placing it in the same way in my book rack also. So totally there are around 500 books here, and as you can see, we have counted it until here, it's around 400 books.
So books which I'm going to be reading frequently, I will be keeping it in the lower shelves, and the other ones I'll be keeping on the higher shelves. But generally what I do is, which I want to read, I take out few of those books and place it on my other shelves or on the table, and once I read them, I keep them back and keep replacing and shuffling the books. I think most of the books we have read it more than once or twice. It's not that once you have read and you're done with the book. Especially my husband would have read many of the books at least 2-3 times. And it's much easier to pick out whichever book you want. As you can see, now the books look so neat, and I can even find out which author I want to read. So you too can make use of such kind of hidden spaces in your house to create small nooks where you can store your things. Doesn't this look neat and organized? So tell me if any of these authors are your favorites, and if you have any ideas about how you store books in your house, please do share it in the comments. I will be coming back with another video where I'll show you all the children books and which were of my childhood and of my daughters also. So how did you like this organizing idea? Do let me know in the comments. And if you like this video, don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel. I will be bringing you a lot of other organization ideas in the coming videos.